Welcome to my channel, AJ's Classes for UGC NET. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to quickly solve a commonly asked question from the square of opposition. The question is, if the statement all students are intelligent is true, which of the following statements are false? Your options are A, no students are intelligent, B, some students are intelligent, and C, some students are not intelligent. You first have to identify the form of the statement by looking at its quantity and quality. In terms of quantity, a statement is said to be universal if it talks about all the items in a category and uses words such as all or every. A statement is said to be particular if it talks about only some of the items in a particular category and uses words such as some or some not. In terms of quality, a statement is affirmative if it is a positive statement and negative if it has the words no or are not. A universal affirmative statement is denoted by the letter A, while E denotes a universal negative statement, I denotes a particular affirmative statement, and O denotes a particular negative statement. So the statement in our question, all students are intelligent, is a universal affirmative statement and is denoted by the letter A. Let's assign the other letters E, I, and O to the statements. Option A, no students are intelligent, is universal negative, so it's assigned the letter E. Option B, some students are intelligent, is particular affirmative and is assigned the letter I. And option C, some students are not intelligent, is particular negative and is assigned the letter O. Keeping this in mind, we're now going to look at the square of opposition, that is AEIO. All you have to do is remember the following rules. Rule number one, A and O are contradictory to each other, which means if one is false, the other must be true. In the same way, E and I are contradictory to each other. Rule number two, A and E are contrary to each other, which means both statements can be false together, but both can't be true together. However, I and O are sub-contraries, which means both statements can be true together, but both can't be false together. Rule number three, I is the subaltern of A, and O is the subaltern of E, which means A and E are superalterns. The rule says that if the superaltern is true, then its subaltern is also true. And if the subaltern is false, then its superaltern is also false. So let's look at our question again and find the relationship between A and the letters E, I, and O. Remember, A and E are contraries. We know that both statements can be false together, but both can't be true together. So since A is true, E cannot be true too. Therefore, E is false. Next, A is the superaltern of I, which means if A is true, then A's subaltern I is also true. Lastly, A and O are contradictories, which means if A is true, then O is false. So the correct answer to the question is option A, no students are intelligent, and option C, some students are not intelligent. If you like this video, do hit the like button, share it, and subscribe to my channel, AJ's Classes for UGC NET, for more videos.